Examining the murder mystery comedy film genre. Generally, a murder mystery focuses on the investigation of a murder or series of murders typically committed during the opening act. A detective or someone else will try to solve the case. Throughout the story, evidence about the killer's motives and identity is compiled through crime scene examinations and hearing testimony from the supporting cast, which usually includes red herrings trying to fool the audience. The comedy comes in when the characters have comedic, sarcastic lines throughout the investigation or an exaggerated personality. The film will end with the killer's identity being revealed. Let's take a closer look at one of the murder mystery comedy films, Knives Out, which came out in 2019 and was written and directed by Rian Johnson. This story follows a private detective, Benoit Blanc, and Marta Cabrera, the victim's nurse, investigating the death of the patriarch of a wealthy, dysfunctional family. Knives Out has formal elements and motifs that define a specific genre. First, for mise-en-scene, the setting is typically in either a grand house or a grand location. In Knives Out, the story is set in Harlan Thrombey, the victim's extravagant house. Costumes are also very unique to each character so that the audience can easily differentiate between the characters and their personalities. The lighting that is typically used is either high-key or low-key. For scenes with more suspense and a dramatic build-up, low-key lighting is typically used. For sound, there is also the use of non-diegetic dramatic score, especially during suspenseful scenes. And sometimes sound effects can be heightened in order to frighten the audience, build suspense, or emphasize something.
We don't want to attack you with this, but Marta, your mother came into the country illegally, criminally, and you come into this inheritance with all the scrutiny that entails, I'd be afraid that could come to light. And that's what we want to avoid here.
The typical narration for this genre and that is displayed in Knives Out is a mix of cause and effect, restricted, and non-linear. For cause and effect, we have the characters as the causes since someone murdered Harlan Thrombey, which led to the effect setting up the rest of the story of trying to find the killer. There is also restricted narration because we, as the audience, are restricted to only what Marta knows about what happened to Harlan. Like Marta, we also don't know who is sending her threats. Finally, for non-linear narration, we are given flashbacks of what different characters did before the death of Harlan Thrombey, which tells us what happened and sets up the rest of the story. Here is an example from the movie of a flashback.
Up, up.
I got it.
Up, up, up. I got it. Up, up, up. I got it.
Okay, that's... Hey, Harlan.
For cinematography, there are a lot of close-ups and medium shots employed, especially as the characters try to piece the clues together and solve the mystery. Handheld camera shots are also used to emphasize the stressful and chaotic behavior from the characters. Finally, at the end of the movie, there is a very interesting technique used, the dolly zoom, which emphasizes the scary moment when Ransom lunges at Marta with a knife. For editing, the 180-degree line is employed throughout the entire film, especially when characters try to piece together clues. There is also a lot of establishing space editing so that we are aware of where the events that led up to the murder took place, so we can understand the whole story. Finally, this genre, as is displayed by the movie, uses a lot of cross-cutting editing when the characters piece together what happened to solve the mystery. The cross-cutting is done from the present storyline to the past. Here is an example from when Detective Blanc pieces together the mystery and explains how he knows Ransom tried to kill Harlan and was behind Marta's blackmail.
And you know, if Marta was responsible for his death, even unintentionally, the Slayer ruled. Would nullify the change will and you would get your share back. You use the syringes in the kit to switch the liquids and the two medication vials. And as a final precaution, you took the naloxone, the life-saving antidote.
Cross-cutting between the present and past storylines allows the mystery to be unraveled visually before the audience. One of the film's ideological functions, and a common ideological function for this genre of film, is that with enough incentive, anyone can become a liar to get what they want. In the movie, before the mystery is solved, every character is seen as guilty, and everyone lies in some way to avoid suspicion. Ransom, who was previously believed to be innocent by Marta, ended up lying to her in order to frame her for Harlan's murder and get his cut of the inheritance, because it had previously been revealed that Harlan had given all of his inheritance to Marta. Throughout the movie, Marta is physically unable to lie because she vomits when she does. She also is shown to be a good person and does not like to lie. However, in the end, she had enough incentive of capturing the murderer of Fran, another character, and finding out if Ransom was behind the blackmail and the attempted murder of Harlan. She was able to lie to Ransom for a short while before she threw up, and in the end, the truth came out.